seeing Duck Hunt Dog. So these are going to be two projectile-heavy characters going at it.
Yeah, this will be... I've been interested in seeing how Link plays now. And he's gonna have to find out. He doesn't have a bomb out yet. Finally.
Alright, unsafe on shield. That's gonna be a grab combo. Tries to check the chase on the platform with the up air.
Another grab, but not getting anything. Seeing Link without his tether grab just looks funny.
Yep. So one thing that Rin definitely likes to do is that, like, his Link skills have just kind of remained the same, but the way that he utilizes bomb is really interesting, because it's not like a lot of other Link mains that I've seen where they kind of utilize bomb and then just start to hit it around or Z-drop it or anything. Kind of uses bomb kind of as a trap tool and really doesn't use it a whole lot on offense, except for, like, a couple of really rare instances.
And I want to talk about what Rin just did at that ledge, getting the jump tech, and he was going to up B towards the jump tech.
Yep.
Knock him off stage. Another great use of up B out of shield. Strong things out of shield, especially up B's, with grab out of shield being weaker.
Yeah, and that's one thing, yeah. Up B out of shield for Link is still very, very strong. Utilizing the bombs just kind of control the space a little bit, forcing Ryo to go on one side of the stage, and the up tilt's going to take that first stock.
Yeah. Dash up tilt will do a lot of work. Downer just protecting Link.
The utilization of the bombs, good placement. Some pretty good damage. That can, though, that's going to take the stock there.
Yeah, but Boomerang immediately going to get Raito a bit in disadvantage. Oh, I thought that was going to poke.
I honestly thought that if it was going to hit, it was going to break his shield because it was really, really low. But the gunman coming in and saving him.
Raito getting these setups, almost going for the dare, but F smash not just not connecting. He was a bit high up in it.
Backer sending Rin off stage. Oh, the bomb! It blew himself up. He's gonna be able to recover just a little bit, but no, went too low. And now Raito up 2-1.
And with Rin's shield down, Raito is just going in on Rin right now.
That's the one inherent weakness that I've seen in all of Rin's play from Link, is that as soon as somebody's in his face, that's usually when things start to break down and the defense just isn't there. Because really the only thing that he has is a quick get off of me option. Like, the two things he has is possibly Nair out of shield and up B out of shield. But a lot of them are kind of a high commitment option, so if he gets stuck in a tough spot, there's really nothing that he could do.
Now, bomb in place, just going to be a placeholder there.
Oh my god, that almost comboed.
It's like both of them want to do the same type of combo, and they both get it, but nothing else to be taken with it. No stocks gone.
Bomb on stage. Going to sit pretty on the other side. Not going to offer Rin any help here.
And very stale, but... Yeah.
And that back air is going to seal it out.
Like dealing with Cloud down air, you just go to the side and hit him.
Yep. And that's actually one big problem that is with Rin especially, is that if bomb is on the other side of the stage, you gotta blow it up. And
yep.
You can't have bomb with you on the way down, so you're going to have to get rid of that possible setup. So like, you gotta think about, well, do I take the good with the bad, or do I try to get back to stage without it, or do I really need it? You gotta be really quick in that kind of decision making, especially when Raito is applying so much pressure on the ledge.
It's honestly, I feel like this matchup and with how bomb works, it's like Link is in his own game. He's trying to, you know, solve the puzzle. He has to use a limited resource. He only gets one at a time, and use it correctly to get through all these obstacles. He really has to, you know, if he's probably a Zettel player, I don't know if he plays
Zettel games, but Rin is definitely doing a lot to solve this problem, right at the beginning of the match, because he started off really, really hot, but now Raito kind of fighting his way back in.
And I've seen this kind of played by Raito before. Well, he'll start not super hot, and then he eventually just like turns on, is like, okay, I understand how you move now. I'm going to keep at it in your face.
Oh no, he got caught sleeping by the ledge, and that's close to an untackable.
That's really hard
to react to. So one thing I'm also noticing, Rin is kind of adapting to side B. If he's at a distance, he's noticing that arrows go right through side B.
Mm-hmm.
So just starting to kind of figure out, all right, this is how you shut down this. This is how you shut down that. Starting to implement it in his game plan a little bit.
I'm not sure Raito was going to make that back if he didn't get hit by Rin. I'm not sure. He looked really low. But Rin gets back anyway.
Rin at the ledge. That can.
Oh,
be able
yeah.
to make it back.
Duck Hunt can act out of Zuppy now.
Yes.
I was like, all right, you know, we're learning something new every tournament.
All right, and then there, neutralizes the gunman. Pulling out the boomerang.
Ah, that looked like it poked.
Well, yeah, once again, getting hit. Like, getting hit by that can, especially at these kinds of high percent, you really don't want to be messing with that kind of thing.
Now, Rydos, wow, the gunman sending him high.
It's just that at this kind of percent, Raito has been locked down at the ledge, not allowing Rin to breathe. Like, Rin has not had stage control in a very long time, but he gets it there with that down air.
I love it. Just the most hero of time down air. Just like, you know what? Double jump over the obstacle down air. Fastball down air. I'm going to end it. But he ended that stock, but it's not enough. He has so much percent to make up here.
Raito is definitely not making it easy for him. He's definitely doing a good job of setting up the wall. And the gunman, that's going to kill. Up two stocks to one. Raito firmly in the driver's seat.
There's so much advantage here between the time and between the percent stocks, but F Smash not going to even it out.
Rin has an opportunity here. He needs to capitalize. He needs to take this stock now. If he does so, then it's a dead even game.
I'm liking that he's going to these F Smashes. He knows.
Like, he's acknowledging that there are lots of opportunities that he's missing. He needs to be brave in order to get some of that damage or possibly even an early kill option. Raito's at 95%. He just needs to get him by the ledge and possibly that might get him into a situation where he can take the stock.
Wow.
Three. Oh, and he almost had the setup.
Man, Raito, you can't just leave us hanging like that. You can't just leave us.
So that's the one thing that I learned really quick is very good for Duck Hunt in this game because our resident Duck Hunt player, Chevy, he likes hitting that kind of stuff all the time.
Clay Pigeon's so strong.
Clay Pigeon's comboing into itself.
You're
going
stage.
On the ride.
He really
Here we go!
There it is!
And that's all you need. You just need the clay pigeons, and it just works
Man.
Itself out.
Sweet relief. I'm so happy Raito went for it again. Just because, like, you can't just leave us hanging. We know what's coming. We need a resolution here.
It's like, you know what? You're going on a ride. Hope you enjoy it. See the sights.
And honestly, to see you get hit by the same kill setup, and seeing the first one Raito just messed up, and Raito's like, let me try again. I want this specifically.
I think I know what's wrong here. Let me just like tweak this little, like, let's just go in and change the number a little bit. All right, we're good to go.
All right, so Battlefield is the change. I'm wondering how much of a difference the platform layout is gonna make here. He may have a few extra traps with platforms. He may be able to do more with his sword on these platforms.
That is true. Link does have options to more chases, more opportunities to shark, more opportunities to apply pressure. But the problem is that you have to get into an advantage state beforehand, and Raito is just not letting Rin breathe at all.
I don't think Raito likes being in losers. That's what I think.
Yeah, he's just like, you know, disadvantage state? What's that? I've never been there.
It's like, I lost. I'm not losing until top 8.
Yeah. Playtime's over. Like I said, it's party time. Break out the glow sticks. Hey, what's this pill? I'll take it.
Still, Rin has not taken a percent, and look at that projectile doing the tech chase. The 0% Link special, but no longer has access to that extra range. Ooh, I like the bomb setup, but Clay Pigeon being in the way, preventing Rin from doing anything fancy.
Like, that's kind of been the story of this entire set, is that Rin has just been trying to get a setup going, trying to get any sort of damage that he can, but Raito has been so good with his projectile play and just his overall placement of gunman, clay pigeon, that it's just been throwing a wrench in it every single time that Rin tries to get any offense started. Once again, it's been smothering.
Finally gets out of the corner, but Raito runs away. Up B out of shield will do it. still very strong. Yeah, what's that bomb doing?
it's just hanging out.
It's a very bouncy ball.
Yep. That's why I like that bomb. It's just you can do so much stuff off of it just by, you know, setting it down and hitting it. It just opens the door to a lot of different possibilities.
Ooh, up B out of shield there, though. Not safe. The aerial was fine. There wasn't a parry to make it much safer. Gonna take that stock from a ticket, that stock lost to an up smash.
Yeah, things not looking so good for Rin right now, as Raito is on match point.
All these little chips too, it's not even just projectiles. Raito's controlling the jump space very well with his own duck bear.
Yeah, and the thing about this is that, like, with all these options and everything is landing, it's mentally exhausting.
Mm-hmm.
Like, you have to pay attention to so much, but if you're paying attention to everything and understanding where everything is and you're still getting hit and you're still playing from this far behind, yeah, it's rough.
It's like in Smash 4, when Duck Hunt was first revealed and he played sort of like Snake, the Snake mains were like, yo, let's try this. That's kind of the style Duck Hunt still has. He's controlling all this space, there's so much to get around, and Link just doesn't have enough to go through this, and Rin hasn't solved enough puzzles yet to reach the next level.
Try for an anti-air option though, but Raito coming down with the safe landing. Up B tried to get off of, but up tilt. There we go. That's the up out of shield that he was looking for. Rin at 164.
Okay.
Not saying that this is within the realm of possibility, but Rin's gotta play his cards perfectly if he wants to bring this back.
Can't be clay pigeon. He can't be clay pigeon
He can't get hit by clay pigeon, can't get hit by can, and certainly can't get hit by gunman. And it's slowly becoming a last hit scenario. Rin's still doing everything he can to stay alive. Forward throw, bomb thrown off stage.
But look at the
this
can.
This is very dangerous. Coming up on ledge, and that's going to do it.
Nowhere to go. Duck Hunt's here. Gunman's aiming at the ledge. Can going at the jump height.
Yeah, absolutely nothing he could have done. Raito with a very